I'm in Mexico right now, and now I'm a believer about the woman here. American woman and Mexican woman are not the same. They're completely different. Bro, it's almost like they're different tribes. Most girls you see in LA are like, oh, I'm a queen, boss, bee, and they're not even that cute. Here, I swear, I'm not joking. Girls are like 8, 9, and 10s, and you guys know I don't like to use numbers, but you know what I mean. And they are super proud. They're super, and we're proud, I mean, just like they carry themselves, they're super warm-hearted, they open, they're not as bougie, they're not arrogant. And the biggest thing, they don't care about having intimacy with so many people to chase validation. They still believe in love. I didn't completely believe it when people said, oh, they're so different. They are so different. They are way easier to be around. Try it out for yourself. The Western social media culture brainwashed these young girls into, yeah, girl, you a boss bee, and they need to learn how to handle you. What do you mean handling you? This is supposed to be a relationship. This is not a battlefield. I'm telling you guys, firsthand experience, it's just fun to be around these people in general. Like, they believe in love. It's fun to be around these girls. I'm gonna keep you guys updated, but this culture is wonderful.
What percentage of modern women are marriage material?
Let me be honest. It's not very many. You know why? Women are in tune to their body. They're not in tune with running a household. They're in tune to social media. They're not in tune with the needs of their significant other or their kids. That, you know, I'm just gonna be honest. The women really is like, fuck men. It's all about me. And I don't know if it comes from the fucked up experience that they've had or. I don't know.
Okay, wait, let me just, wait. Okay. Wait, can I just finish one more thing? Okay. And one more thing about that. Why then, if that's true, why do we have the expression, where have all the good men gone, but nobody's asking, where have all the good women gone?
Oh, they do.
We're privileged.
From where I'm from?
We're the fucking prize. And if women don't know that, we're the prize. Fuck a nigga, we're the prize.
We don't talk enough about how passport bros are just predators.
I'm not a predator if I sleep with women in America, but if I sleep with women outside of America, I'm a predator. Got you. Guess that means you stop sleeping with people in different states too, right? You live in Florida, don't sleep with somebody in Chicago, you're a predator. Logic. The obesity rate in a different country is not as high as America. Stay here and sleep with all the mammoths. Got it? Women in other countries are nice and they look good. Stay here. Deal with somebody who's nice but don't look good. Or deal with somebody who looks good and wants to rob you passively. Nice. I don't think she used logic. I don't think logic matters to her. She's not happy at all. She keeps on forgetting to use her Planet Fitness membership.
It's a lot of things that women in today's society don't understand. And they will never understand. For you to even try to negotiate, try to barter with them, make them understand it, they can't understand because the feminist ideology has just absorbed in every crevice of their brain to the point where it's like they lost. You know what I'm saying? No matter how pretty, no matter how, whatever you put them on the scale, to the point every one of them think they are 10. Okay? And with you as a man, ask yourself, man, like seriously, genuinely, ask yourself, what is the point? What is the goal? What are you going to get out of this situation outside of box? There's nothing here. There's nothing there. Okay. When you understand how ill-valuable that actually is on a global scale, where there's literally there's tens and thousands of women that literally want you and they think it's belittling themselves to do these things for you. We're going to really capitalize that on this very next clip. Let's check it out.
Do you eventually want marriage and family?
Of course.
Do you eventually want marriage and family?
Yes, I have the career now.
Okay, do you eventually want marriage and family?
Yeah.
So here's the reality. If you don't want it, then how are you relevant to the conversation? Because high-value men don't want you. Because they want marriage and family.
But that's a paradox. Because you guys say, oftentimes you guys say, women, your number one like goal in life is to be married. But I don't think that you hold men to the same standard. You guys say men, they don't really need to settle down. They can have their own circle of ladies that they kind of juggle. I mean, I don't know if this is what you guys say, but I'm just saying from the last podcast that I was on. This is the only thing that's going to give you meaning and value in your life. And I do know there's a lot of studies that do support that women are happier in marriages. But if we don't have the opportunity or the choice to do other things, we're not going to want to be in marriage.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that the kind, if the kind of man that you want, the highly high value, highly desirable man, whatever you want to call it, you want him, right? You want to be married. You may not want a family by him.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to be with somebody who is,
yes,
to me, is amazing.
So the reality of the matter is you have to make that a priority in your life. And what happens for too many women is that in your 20s, you will sacrifice all the things that make you desirable to that man, and you end up becoming a man. You end up getting all these masculine skills.
That's a lot of shade to the male population.
There's no shade to male population. If you guys are taking on masculine traits, then that's only hurting you.
First of all, I mean, what do you mean by masculine traits? Because I think the traits that I think are the most prominent with me are creativity, you know, innovation, or whatnot. Those are not necessarily masculine traits. That's not male or
social dynamic. You are a very assertive individual and a very dominant individual.
But that's just my personality. It's not something. It's not like I can change.
No,
that,
but here's the problem.
And I wouldn't want to.
If there was a guy whose personality was naturally more passive, naturally more submissive, for a lot of women that wouldn't be attractive. So just because it's the way you are doesn't negate the fact that nobody wants it.
I think I should always better myself, but I don't think that I should change myself to please a man.
So you don't have to, you're right. You don't have to change yourself to please a man. But what you got to realize is if you don't possess what the man wants, you can't get mad at the man.
But there's a lot of different types of men out there.
But that's the problem is you want all the types of men. You literally said you want this top of the line caliber of man. So if you wanted a different type, if you wanted a 50-50 egalitarian, effeminate man,
I don't want
more
that.
Exactly. That's the problem. You want a more masculine, assertive, ambitious.
But I haven't had any trouble.
Hold on. You said earlier that you want a partnership, though, but I wasn't listening.
No. I think a partnership means that somebody will support you and help you in whatever goals you have.
And the problem is that you want, let me tell you the fundamental thing. The type of man that you want has options. He can choose Israel, India, Egypt.
Can I say I wouldn't want a man who didn't choose me?
Listen,
out of a few.
Beautiful. He has options. The challenge is what you are bringing to the table, what you want, the other girls are not going to fight him for. You want him to support and join your team as well. These other two girls, India and Egypt, say, I will just join this team. I'm not trying to do all those. They have the advantage over you. You are combative. Mm-hmm. You are combative. When talking to you, we're going to have to argue. With those girls, you don't have to argue. So the challenge is going to be, why would he choose
but
them
wouldn't,
over
wouldn't
you?
A man get bored by a woman who doesn't have any opinion or that's, care at all?
That, okay. So,
last thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
And that's the fundamental problem. So many women want to tell men what they like. Wouldn't a man not like that? Wouldn't a man? No, we're not you. Women keep on living in a world where they think they're men. The way I feel about men is the way men feel about women. No. And so the unfortunate reality is that is not true. And if you keep on viewing men, the men view women the way you view men, you will keep on experiencing the same negative results over and over again. No. To answer your question, no, they will not get bored. It's actually peaceful.
This is a brief intermission as we check out something real quick, a quick little video to react to and, you know, break something down real quick. 2-3 minutes, 4 minutes, and we'll get back to the content. Let's go into it.
We saw our moms go through with our dad. You're talking about, oh, well, you're never going to get married. Okay, my mom got married and she served my dad hands and feet and she ended up divorcing him because she was sick of his ass.
Because
it's only so much you can take.
It can't even just take. You just get tired. You get burnt out for constantly having to care for someone like they're your child.
Literally, I do not remember my mom ever eating.
Which is
she cooked
crazy.
Dinner for my mom, for my dad, for my sister, and for me. And I can't recall a moment when my mom sat down to eat because she was eating while cooking for us because she didn't have.
This is pure emotion. This is pure emotion. She can't recall a moment her mom sat down and ate food as a human. Come on, y'all. But the point is this. This is an important point right here. The number one point is this. Number one, these women aren't what passport bros are getting. But this woman right here is so scorned that she's going to use this as her example for why passport bros won't work. On top of the fact, this is, we're not, I'm no offense to anybody, but I'm not these people. I'm not Dominican. I'm not any of these other cultures, no offense to them. With all due respect, and I don't believe this is commonplace. This could have been, we don't know if this is common. We don't know if this is, it's all dependent upon the man and the individual. You know what I'm saying? So we really can't put that on that. But I really want y'all to see how they're trying to paint this narrative as if Passport Bros are going to go overseas and become like these men. I have none of these tendencies. I have no reason to put my hand on a woman. Why would I need to do that? If I even have to think about that, I'm not even going to be with that woman. That means she's a woman that I don't want to be with, no matter what country. All right? So this is just basic common sense. And on top of that, these two women that are speaking, that she's using as an example, they look more Americanized. Like they've been part of the things that Passport Bros talk about is we're not taking these women back to our home countries, because look at the mentality. She said she divorced him. There's no other country outside of the first world where a woman can divorce a man and she be set up financially, because it's not there. Those, they're not taken care of by the state. The governments don't have the infrastructure to be able to take care of them for the foreseeable future, not just 1, 2, 3 years. We're talking about 10, 15, 20 years moving forward, and have certain incentives in place for her to be taken care of. These things are not there. But let's continue.
The time. You think that I'm gonna do that?
That's sad. As a child looking at your mom, that's sad to witness.
You, right, you need to understand why I'm such a savage and why I'm so angry. You know what I'm saying? Thankfully, I have a...
So this is her origin story. This is her origin story. Why she's so angry. You know what I'm saying? Why she's so upset. Like, this is nothing. She's so angry and villainous that she's a lot of women. This is on a smaller scale, but a lot of women take their traumas and then they use that against you. You understand? They put that, they use these things and they try to use it against you. When, like, bro, we got traumas too, but when you come to a woman, you got to be prepared to let all that go. Like, I don't got all my traumas, bro, from what I went through. Y'all wouldn't even know, because I don't break those down too much. But I'm from the inner city, things of that nature. You know what that is. You know what I'm saying? And overall, listen, that doesn't matter though. All right, I'm still blessed. I'm still, you know, so I don't care about none of that, man. All those traumas, man, those things of the past, and I've overcame those things from a psychological point of view. So you just got to overcome them. And it's not, and be honest with you, if you're in America, it's not hard to do. All right, I'm not saying it's easy, because it's still traumas. It's in yourself. It's you versus yourself, but it's not impossible. All right.
That understands, that's considerate of me, that knows that if I cook and sometimes I want to serve him, I'll serve him. Right. But sometimes when I say, yo, the food is ready, come get it, he has no problem.
He knows what that means.
And then after that, he goes and washes the dishes to help me out.
Because it's an equal part.
And look, do you see this at the bottom? I wonder if they were BM. Like, what does this have to, people, like I said, it's these people. Let me tell you, right. These people, bro. These people, we're not gonna use any names. Specifically, these group of people are just so bent on us. This has nothing to do if he was that. She said he was Dominican. Okay? She looks like she's biracial. He could have been anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, it don't make any sense. They so caught up on what dudes is doing. This is not even about BM. This is this is generational from across the board. All right? Across the board. No matter the race, skin, color, or creed, or religion, all right?
On. One hand washes the other. It's not give, 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 and then you just take. But that's not how it works.
Time out. If you going over there and you paying, you basically doing things, taking care of the whole situation, where is give, 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 give? What are you getting in return for real? This is why you know these women are, like I said before, Americanized. But let this woman say something real quick before we go move on.
Well, what happened? I thought that they were talking about how these women were so submissive, how they were getting all of this. This is what they want, right? But this woman said this is why she's so angry and she's a savage. This is what she says. And now I understand why the passport bros are tired on this land, because what they're wanting is a mat, not a mate. And they're going from community.
Do you see this? The logical mental level, some people just won't. I thought everybody had the ability to have a certain level of aptitude to be able to understand these type of concepts. It's just not there. They just can't. You see this face she's making right here? Look at her face. She cannot comprehend. She cannot comprehend. She don't know what's going on. This is a major L. This is a major L. But what do we expect? They cannot comprehend that men are going away. She thinks that we're gonna, first of all, these not even the women are, you call this submissive? Listen, these aren't submissive, and we're not going for these type of women. There's enough, there's an endless supply. Okay, I'm gonna go into other videos about that as well, but endless supply. Okay, all right, let her finish a couple words she's gonna say to me. We're gonna get up out of here.
To community, burning all of these bridges and finding out that women have choices, women have options, and they have autonomy. But this is basically.
Autonomy. Listen. Listen. No. This is delusion. This is what I'm talking about. Logical, man. They only have autonomy in the first world. While you as a man, you have autonomy on the globe. You understand? It's a difference. It's a difference, man. But nonetheless, man, let's continue going back to that content, man. Y'all know what it is. It's nothing you can do with these type of women, man. Let's go check out the rest of the content. All I'm doing is showing you really quick is this is content that's on the horizon. As you see at the very bottom, it tells you when it's coming out, what type of content we're talking about, how we're going to, you know, talk about it. It's going to be a breakdown, talking, whatever. And also, when I release them, I'm going to have it released. All those videos are going to be in the description or my comment. You can find them below when they come out and they release. And I'll be saying coming soon, all that. But let's get back to the content. I just want my guys on my channel to know what's coming up.
And I've had good relationships in my life, but I have never felt like a king or got true king treatment until I went out of this country.
Facts.
Where you're praised, especially as a black man, and one, I'm from America,
yeah.
And two, I'm black.
For being you, right.
It's like the world is yours whenever you leave this country.
Listen, I've traveled over 12 countries. He's absolutely correct.
Chris Rich.
Nobody tells you about marriage. The brutal truth. A man offers provisions and protection from the moment he says, I do. This is his duty, and he does not deviate, deprive, or withhold it from his partner. It is consistent. A woman offers beauty, loyalty, and sexual exclusivity from the moment she says, I do. This is her duty, and she will deviate from it from time to time, regardless of a man's consistency. Every month, a man pays bills. He does not take a break. Every month, a woman cooks and cleans. She will take breaks. Every day, a man secures his home. He does not take a break. Every day, a woman maintains beauty and health. She will take a break. When a wife turns sex into privilege and withholds it, he does not take a break. When a woman lets herself go and become lazy, he does not take a break. When a woman goes into menopause and no longer wishes to sexually please her man, he does not take a break. When a wife and husband argue and fight and separate, they both may cheat, he does not take a break. A woman completely shuts off access from the time of separation up until divorce. If a man take a break, all will perish. If a man isn't consistent, all will fail. So let's stop questioning men who exercise their options.
So in general, men, ask yourself, why are they trying to build this narrative against you, that you some type of horrible human? You know, we know what we're doing, man. We know what we're doing is not illegal. You know what I'm saying? We know what we're doing is not, illegal in any aspect or has any type of malice or hate or anything. We don't have any of that in our hearts, man. I don't think I'm better than any of these people. Just because I'm financially in the position that I'm in doesn't mean anything. These women will make it seem like these women shouldn't even don't deserve resources or don't deserve a man who can provide, all because she's in a impoverished situation. It makes no sense, because they are the ones who think they are better than other individuals. I don't think I'm better than any of these men in their respective countries. I mean, just the way the cookie crumbles, you know. I really believe men aren't valued solely based off of their income. That's only the female perspective of how they look. I look at men on a variety of different things, and what I think
you should want to emulate as a man, who you would want to be in your inner circle, who you would want to be in your friend group, integrity, respect, certain qualities that you would want your son to have, for, you know, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? These are things that I think Passport Bros in general, because we also want to be able to be in our children's lives. And if you stay in this first world, you know, that's not going to be a possibility. You know, weekends, like, we're not talking about the whole system in itself. Like I said before, it was never meant for you to be successful. All right. But you have the ability to do certain things that, you know, God has given you the ability to do in this situation. So take advantage of them. You know, make sure you make the right decisions. Overall, man, I appreciate you if you got to this point in the video. Like I say all the time, hit that like, subscribe, all that good jazz. Like I showed you before, I got so much good content on the way for my guys that we can truly absorb and really have this discussion. Overall, man, I appreciate you. And I know what to do. Get that MPS up, your mental, physical, and your spiritual. It's your GPS on life. It's going to help you in all aspects. And it's going to make you be the greatest person that you want to be. You already know what it is, man. I'm going to catch you on the next one. Let's get it.